Hi, I'm Michael Guy, MTN's World Superbike reporter. We're here at Silverstone. We're just days away from the British round of the World Superbike Championship. We're here, we're going to meet up with James Toseland. We're going to go up in a helicopter, have a look around the track, and hopefully we're going to go and do some laps with him and see how the new circuit actually is. Okay, we're here with James Toseland at Silverstone. James, we've been up in a helicopter. What did you make of that, seeing the track from the air? Obviously, first time seeing it.
It looked great. I mean, I was a bit nervous about the helicopter, to be fair, at first. But it's really interesting to see it from a bird's eye view like that. Because obviously I know half of it, but not the second half. So to see the whole track from that angle first before I went out for a few laps was really helpful. You just actually see the spectrum of what this place is. You know, the motocross tracks and the skid pan, and you know the smaller tracks here. It's just a massive complex.
For sure, yeah. And you did actually manage to do one flying lap, quite an interesting one. I was following you.
I nearly had you as a brilliant.
Can you talk us through the last corner?
It's a bit bumpy and a bit slippy just on the exit of that one. But yeah, it was all under control, the whole thing, really. Even when the legs are flapping and it looks kind of slightly out of control, you know, it's the flapping is what keeps it in control.
Right, good to know.
As you know.
A professional. And coming back to the race and your season so far, you've had four podiums so far this year. It's been quite a difficult season, I think it's fair to say. You know, yourself and Cal have both had kind of traction issues throughout the year and electronic issues. But you're coming off a very strong result at Bruno, essentially last in the first corner to finish in fourth. What are your aspirations for the race? And how do you think the Yamaha is going to work around a track like this?
I think the Yamaha is going to be fine. When you can keep the revs up with the Yamaha and keep, because there's less torque in the higher revs with the R1, and it seems to find a bit more grip in that range. So this is definitely going to be one of the fastest tracks on average around the actual circuit. It's probably going to be the longest track that we do as well. It's over a 2-minute lap, isn't it? As you saw from MotoGP. So, but yeah, I'm really looking forward to it. Bruno, my launch control failed in both races, and to go into the first corner last after the season that we'd been having as well, I was a bit frustrated. So I passed 10 people on the first lap and then clawed my way up to fourth, which in the end wasn't a bad result. But when you look at the lap times and you realise you could have definitely been comfortably on the podium, but then, you know, it's frustrating for us. So. You know, there's been three Brits on the podium before, and there's no reason why this one. You know, Leon Haslam's been riding great this season, second in the championship. Cammy's been riding great on the podium. My teammate's been riding good on the R1. So, you know, there's definitely a chance of all three of us being on the podium, and you know, I'm coming to be a part of it as well. I haven't won a race this year, and you know, there's been a couple of places where it's been close to winning, like at Monza. So the pace is there. We just got to perform at home.
Great stuff. Thanks very much, James.
Cheers.